Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a simple rib crop top. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And for this top, it's easy to wear and take off because the stitches of this top is super stretching. So for this top, I make for size small, but for size medium also can fit. And for you guys that make bigger size, like size large or extra large, I will tell you how to make the top bigger and longer in this video. Okay, now let's get into the video. For this top, I use milk cotton yarn size DK with 4.5 mm crochet hook. If you guys don't have milk cotton yarn, you can use any type of yarn that's soft and lightweight for crochet the top. To begin, make a slip knot. And then make the foundation chains. To chain, yarn over and pull through the loop. Keep repeating this until you got 38 chains. It is equal 9 inches. It's the height of the top. If you guys want your top longer, please add more chains. Remember, make sure your foundation chain is the even number. After you got your desired length, next we are going to make the ribbing part. For row 1, skip 1 chain and make slip stitch into the next chain. Don't forget to pull the yarn on your hook a little bit loose. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first slip stitch. It is easy to know where your first stitch or the last stitch is. Please keep repeating this into the next 3 chains. Remember, when you make the slip stitch, please pull the yarn on your hook a little bit loose. After you got 4 stitches of slip stitch, next we are going to make the moss stitch. To begin, make a single crochet into the next stitch. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet. It is easy to know where to start making the ribbing part, which is the slip stitch part. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 chain, and make single crochet into the next chain. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 chain, and make single crochet into the next chain. Keep repeating this into every chain until you have 8 last chains, then I will meet you back again. After you got 8 last chains, and next, we are going to add 1 more single crochet stitch into the next chain. After you have made a single crochet, then we are going to make the ribbing part by make slip stitch into every chain until the end of the row. And now you must have 7 stitches of slip stitch. And this is what the first row looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and then we are going to make slip stitch but into the back loop of the stitch only. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this first slip stitch. It is easy to know where your first stitch or the last stitch is. Keep making slip stitch back loop only into the next 6 stitches. In total, you must have 7 stitches of slip stitch back loop only. Then I will meet you back again. After you have made a ribbing part, then make the mask stitch by making single crochet into the single crochet stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 single crochet stitch, and make single crochet into the chain space. Keep repeating this until you have 5 last stitches or until you reach the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch marker, then we are going to make single crochet into the stitch where we mark. After you have made a single crochet, then we are going to make slip stitch back loop only into the next 4 stitches. And this is what the second row looks like. Next, for row 3 and row 4, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make slip stitch back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row. So for row 3 and row 4, we are not making the mask stitch, just make slip stitch back loop only into every stitch. Remember, when you're making the slip stitch, please make it loose so it is easy to insert the hook when you make slip stitch for the next row. And if you make it too tight, then the mask stitch, your top will curve or ruffle. this is what it looks like when I reach row 4. You can see it's a little bit curved, but you just pull and stretch it a little bit to give a nice and straight row. Next, for row 5, chain 1, turn your work and make slip stitch back loop only into the next 4 stitches. After you got 4 stitches of slip stitch, next we are going to make the moss stitch by making single crochet into the next stitch. Make sure that you're working the single crochet stitch into both loops. Keep making the moss stitch until you have 8 last stitches or until you reach the stitch marker. Then we are going to make the ribbing part. After you reach the stitch near stitch marker, then remove the stitch marker and we are going to make single crochet into that stitch. After you have made a single crochet, then make slip stitch back loop only into the next 7 stitches. And this is what the 5th row looks like. Next, for row 6, chain 1, turn your work and make slip stitch back loop only into the next 7 stitches. It is for the ribbing part. After you have made a ribbing part, then make the moss stitch by making single crochet into the single crochet stitch. Then chain 1, skip 1 single crochet stitch and make single crochet into the chain space. Keep repeating this until you have 5 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you have 5 last stitches, then make single crochet into this last single crochet stitch. And next, make slip stitch back loop only into the next 4 stitches. It is for the ribbing part. As you can see, I have 4 stitches of slip stitch. And this is what the 6th row looks like. For the next row, keep repeating by make 2 rows of slip stitch back loop only. Please repeat rows 3 and 4. and then make 2 rows of more stitch. Please repeat row 5 and 6 until you reach row 132. And this is what my top looks like after I reach row 132. It is equal 25 inches is the measurement around my under bust. For the stitches pattern, it is really stretching, so you don't have to worry that it's not gonna fit around your bust. If you guys want your top bigger, please add more rows by repeat 2 rows of more stitch and 2 rows of slip stitch back loop only. Next, we are going to attach both sides together. Please turn your top wrong side out. And then continue from where your last stitch is and continue into the hook into the other side's loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, we are going to make single crochet both sides together by insert the hook into the slip stitch loop and then continue inside the hook into the other side's loop. Yarn over and pull through both sides loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. For the moth stitch side, you have to insert the hook into the single crochet stitch and into the chain space. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Next, we are going to chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Then tie this both tail together. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. And this is what the wrong side looks like. Turn your top right side out. And this is what the right side looks like. As you can see, this top is really stretching, so it is easy to wear. Please try this top on your body and use stitch marker to mark where you want to make the strap. You just mark the front part, and for the back part, we will mark at the same spot like the front part. After you have marked where you want to make the strap, to make sure that both straps are equal, please turn your top to the back part and start counting the number of the row from where we have attached the top. For me, I count 9 rows of the slip stitch part and use stitch marker to mark at the 10th row. And then I count the same number to the other side. And next, we are going to count the number of the row between this bow stitch marker, which is the end arm part. Start counting from the stitch that we mark until the second stitch marker. I have 14 rows. And then you have to count the other side to make sure that it has the same number of the row. And now both sides, I have the same number of the row as you can see. Next, we are going to make the strap. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark. Then make 120 chains. If you guys want your strap more longer, please add more chains. For making the strap, I use smaller hook. If you guys don't have, you can use the same hook. After you got 120 chains, next, skip one chain and make slip stitch into the next chain. Make sure that you make slip stitch a little bit loose. Keep making slip stitch into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Next, we are going to continue make slip stitch into the top. And then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, for the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. And don't forget to repeat the same thing to the other side where we use stitch marker to mark. Then I will meet you back again. And now all the strap is done. You can tie both straps together and make a bowl. Finally, the rib crop top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.